So hey, what's up mga kote? It's me, Ate Mariel, at welcome sa Kodernos, where learning is the name of the game. So kung bago ka pa lamang sa aming YouTube channel, i-click mo na subscribe, like, and share button para may update ka sa aming mga videos. So samahan natin si Super K sa panibagong araw at panibagong lesson na ating matututunan dito sa Kodernos. At ang bagong lesson natin for today is all about sedimentary rocks. So, di ba na pag-aralan na natin nung una, igneous rocks, ngayon naman sedimentary, and next is metamorphic. So, dito, ang goal naman natin is malaman natin saan ba na-form or saan ba nanggagaling yung sedimentary rocks, saan ba siya nanggaling. So, di ba yung igneous rocks nanggaling sa lava, sa magma, pag may volcanic eruption. So, dito naman, aalamin natin saan ba nagmula yung sedimentary rocks. Ano yung properties and example ng sedimentary rocks na maaari nating makita. So, before we start our lesson, so of course, meron tayong panibagong trivia for today. So, speaking of volcanoes, there were active volcanoes on the moon when dinosaurs were alive. So, di ba na tatandaan natin na may instances na nabuhay yung mga dinosaurs. So, if you watch Jurassic World, so, ganun yung mga itsura ng mga dinosaurs. So, may mga iba't ibang klase yan. So, ayan. So, yung merong mga volcanoes sa moon nung buhay pa ang mga dinosaurs. So, most of the volcanoes probably stopped erupting about a billion years ago. But NASA findings have suggested that there might still have been active lava flow 100 million years ago, when dinosaurs were still roaming. So, imagine gano'ng kalaki yung mga dinosaurs noong mga time na yun. Super nakakatakot. So, syempre, yung mga scientists natin as investigative type of human and people, so, they think that there might be an active lava flow 100 million years ago. So, super tagal na nun. So, wala pa tayo sa mundo. Wala pang modernity. Wala pang mga technology. Meron ng sinususpect nila na mayroon pa rin active lava flow 100 million years ago. So, dito naman tayo sa sedimentary rocks. So, every year, a big amount of rock particles, sand, pebbles, and other materials sink to the ocean and sea floors. As millions of years go by, there are materials are pressed tightly together by the weight of other materials above them. This makes the materials stick together and form rocks. So, rocks form out of sediment are called sedimentary rocks. From the world itself, sediment. So, sedimentary rocks are made from sediment. So, of course, yung mga rocks natin dito, madalas pinupulot natin yan minsan, pinaglalaroan, may iba't ibang shape, ginagamit sa piko. So, yan. This makes the materials stick together and form rocks. So, yung rocks na made of sediment. So, yan ang tinatawag na sedimentary rocks. So, yun yung mga sedimentary rocks example natin. So, ayan. Sandstone, conglomerate, shale, and limestone. So, yun yung mga example natin ng sedimentary rocks. So, you have observed that materials falling into a body of water form layers of rocks. Since there are many kinds of sediments that are carried to the oceans, there are also many different sedimentary rocks formed. Sandstone is sedimentary rock. Sandstone is a mass of sand pressed tightly together to form a rock. So, at certain periods also, a large amount of clay gets deposited at the bottom of the ocean. This may be pressed down by other materials or by the weight of ocean water. Shale, which is another type of sedimentary rock, is formed. Shale is soft and breaks into pieces easily. So, sandstone is a din siyang sedimentary rock. From the world itself, sand. So, it is made of sand pressed tightly together to form a rock. So, yung shale is type of sedimentary rock. So, it is soft and breaks into pieces easily. Sand, pebbles, shells, or some other materials that may be pressed together to form a rock. This sedimentary rock is called conglomerate. So, yung conglomerate, nakita nyo ba? Ayan. So, ito yung sandstone. Nawala yata yung ink natin dito. So, ayan. Wala yung ink natin dyan. So, this is the sandstone. Ito yung conglomerate. So, may shale and limestone pa. So, ito yung shale. Ayan. So, ito naman. Which type of sedimentary rock did you make in the previous activity? So, may activity pala na gagawin. But, hindi ko na siya sinama. There is another kind of sedimentary rock, but it is not formed from sediments that come from land. This rock, which is called limestone, is formed from the shells of tiny sea animals. If you drop a little amount of vinegar on piece of limestone, you will notice some bubbles form on the rock. This shows that limestone is made up of calcium carbonate. So, ito yung sinasabi natin limestone. Nights na yan. So, pag dilagyan mo siya ng vinegar or suka, so, magkakaroon ng bubbles doon sa pali, doon sa rock na nilagyan mo ng vinegar. So, kung saan siyang surface, magkakaroon doon siya ng bubble. So, yung limestone is made up of calcium carbonate. So, yan, medyo malabo siya. One of the interesting thing that man learns from sedimentary rocks is the form of animals that live long ago. What will happen when the fish dies and is covered by clay that sinks to the bottom of the sea? It will decay, but it may leave its imprint or trace in the rock. It will become part of a rock. So, diba, tayo din namang mga tao kapag, for example, pag may dead people, of course, nadedecay yung katawan, but there will leave a mark, magkakaroon ng buto. So, ganun din yung nangyayari kapag meron din sa mga animals. So, dito naman, sa rock na to, so, magiging parte na siya ng rock. So, doon nabubuo yung mga fossil, mga traces nila na may ganong nabuhay na animals doon or may namatay doon na animals doon sa part ng rock na yon. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless. So, click the thumbs up button if you like this video and leave a comment down below if you have suggestions, clarifications, and questions to our future videos. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless. See you in my next video. Bye-bye!